We are the fastest growing economy in the world. But we are facing a lot of problems in urban areas and in rural areas. Once upon a time, our 90% of the population belongs to rural area. Now more than 25 to 30% migration is there. And it comes to 65 to 60%. We neglected rural economy. And that is one of the reasons that today we are facing our big, huge problems in urban area. The basically, two things are very important. One is planned development. And second thing is very important concern with air pollution and water pollution. The air pollution and water pollution is a big problem. In the smart cities, we need to plan as a green city where we have to reduce the not only pollution, water pollution, air pollution, but we are expecting that smart cities should be free from all type of pollutions. And that is one of the reasons which is very important for development of all cities in the country. I am just giving you the example. In Delhi, we are facing a lot of problems. Once upon a time, odd and even and a lot of things are there. But now, just 15 days before, we constructed the half ring road of Delhi, 135 kilometer, access control express highway, and one of the 14 lane express highway of the country, part of the Delhi Meerut. Now, we are expecting at least 41% less traffic jam, and at least 35 to 40% the pollution will be reduced. But today, when I get the statistic from the other institution, they are claiming now there is reduction of 27% of pollution in Delhi. Because the traffic from Kashmir, Punjab, Haryana, Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh, going to Rajasthan and Delhi, Uttar Pradesh, going to the central part of the Delhi. And now that all traffic, they need not go to Delhi now. And that is one of the reasons that everywhere there is a pollution level is less. So before that, one of the leading company in Mumbai, with the help of them, we have made the study and research of Delhi pollution and traffic jam. So already they gave me the report and yesterday, and we have decided to give the presentation to the Chief Minister of Delhi and his colleague. Now my department is working on Delhi, making the projects of 40,000 crores. Where one Dwarka Express Highway is there. We have identified the black spots and particularly the traffic jam spots by improving it. I feel that there will be great relief to the people. And I feel that with confidence, I am telling within 2 years, Delhi will be free from air pollution and water pollution. Particularly in water pollution in Delhi, we have selected 12 projects with Delhi state government, out of which 8 projects are already started where JICA is partner. And I'm confident in next year, before May, June, we are going to complete all the projects. Actually, from Clean Ganga mission, the Yamuna and 40 tributaries are very important. We are doing 210 projects, making 125 biodigester in the different part of Uttar Pradesh, Jharkhand, Bengal. And out of 210 projects, already we have completed 47 projects. And I'm expecting that 105 projects are now moving fast. And before March 8 of 19, I am confident that 80% of the Ganga will be clean. So Yamuna, we are at 13, we are going to sign a contract between Indian Oil and my ministry, Namami Gange, for making a big project in Mathura, and that all recycling water we are using for refinery. I feel that here we need a integrated approach. 5 years before I'm member of parliament from Nagpur, we are presently selling our sewage water to government of Maharashtra now. Mr. Mehta was at that time MD, and we signed the agreement. And now the agreement is now, again it is increase for more water, 4000 megawatt power is there. So we are giving all water of sewage water of Nagpur, and that is giving us 78 crore rupees royalty from that. And now in Ganga, we are also in Nagpur also, we are trying to make the agreement with a good company. From that water, they will get methane, and by evaporating methane from CO2, we will get bio-CNG. And the plan is we can run at least 50 to 60 buses on that. So my feeling is to create value in the solid waste and liquid waste is very important. For the smart cities, we have to create the value. Because one thing is very important. If you create the value, people can understand the importance of waste. I feel that the process will move fast. Mr. Ajay Mehta is here. Once upon a time, the flash was a environment point of view is a big problem. But now after research, government has taken a decision that you can mix 35% flash in cement, and they are using in construction. Now there is a demand for flash and political pressure. Everyone wants flash. So now in our power project, in cogeneration, our flash from rice straw, we just make the research for that. And from that flash, we are getting silicon and black carbon. And the silicon, that the flash value is at least is no value is there. But because of 70% silicon, we can getting it from that flash, from rice straw. That can be used for tire and paint industries having the rate of more than 100 rupees per kilo. So I feel that we need the appropriate technology. Regarding the smart cities, the planned development and mobility transport is very important. Now we have to work in two parts. In the all existing cities, we have to prepare a plan, a vision for development where the city will be free from air pollution, water pollution, traffic jam. And it will be a sustainable development will be there, which can be give us a good life to the people of poor people, at the same time the middle class people and other people. Where we need to be good gardeners, good plants. Now with the cooperation of Mr. Ajay Mehtaji, we are planning to make a garden in Mumbai, in the eastern part of sea. Where my planning is 1,000 acre of land. We are making reclamation and we were to create a garden. I was inspired and motivated in Singapore when I seen that garden in reclamation land. And that garden will give oxygen to the people of Mumbai. So with the help of Chief Minister and Mumbai Municipal Corporation, now they have already made provision in the development plan making of that garden. And you just understand how the people create problems. So there was a tender in JNPT for dressing of 2000 crores. And he's taking all that material from 40 to 50 kilometer to the western side of the sea. So we, with the permission, we make all type of resolution and apply to the Environment Ministry. And we are pursuing the thing for many days. But 80% of the work is over. And that material is going to 50 kilometers. After that, they give me the permission. Now only the 20% material is available for reclamation. So in the total project, we have the loss of 400 crores. Actually, if we use that material, the distance was less. That the reason that we have to reduce the cost of the contract. The contractor understands, so he make very fast work because he don't know, he's more business, he want that by taking long distance, he will get more business, more money. And because of that, at least 250 crores of reclamation cost, which we can easily reduce. I remember one thing in Mumbai, where I was minister, I started this Worli Bandra sealing project. And there was one tender for reclamation, that all starting point. One of the contractor, PBA, the Shaggy Lyle, and the very famous people, he quote very less. So my MD tell me it's not practically possible. I said, we'll ask him what is the reason that he is quoting. When I call him that this is not economy, why are you doing it? He say, I have a contract in Pawai, that there is one mountain is there, and I want to take that all mud and settle somewhere. So I will take it, I will take money for that. So I feel free of charge, I will make reclamation here. That's why my cost is very less. So he used the same thing. So now I just requesting Ajay Mehtaji, because we have to find out the solution, economic viability, and reduce the cost. that I'm ready to clean bitumen. But you take the responsibility that whatever the wastage we are getting, we will take it to BPT, whether you take it, we have to take the permission from the Environment Ministry. But I feel that it can be possible, by which your problem will be solved. Now our Bhatia chairman of BPT has given a letter to Metro that whenever whatever the material you have, please give it to BPT. We will give the place and we can make the reclamation for that. So it can be a win-win situation for both the parties. So I feel that this is the time for the country that we have to very seriously think about air pollution and water pollution. We are making 5 cities in the country, particularly the ports, Kandla port, Tuticorin. And now there are a lot of new ideas are there. I'm just giving you one example. I'm a minister for water resources. So you know the what is the water problem in Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. Regarding Kaveri, what are the disputes are there going on? So I just visualize one new group project. I'm working on it. The desalination of water. In Chennai, there is a big project. So the cost of the water for desalination is very high. So I say, why your cost is that? Because the power rate is 6 rupees per unit, something more than that. Then I plan, we have now 15 megawatt project we inaugurated in Kandla, where our power rate is 2 rupees 45 paisa. So we have got the potential of making 2000 megawatt of power, wind power. So we now decided to make the 2000 megawatt power project, wind and solar hybrid. And the power minister of the country, we have now, he's already given us the approval that he will purchase the power. He will charge some 40-50 paisa per unit and he will give that power to all 12 major ports. In Jawaharlal Nehru Port Trust, we are purchasing the power with 11 rupees per unit. So now this power we will getting, it will not more than 2 rupees 50 paisa. So we have decided to, with taking this power, we will make desalination plant in Tuticorin, Kandla and Paradip. By giving power by less than 3 rupees, our desalination plants water will be available, sweet water available with 3 paisa per liter. So as compared with the irrigation project, because I am doing all these big projects in river connectivity, lot of project cost 50,000 crore, 60,000 crore. So I suggest my Central Water Commission, that CWC, did a study. What is the cost of water in irrigation project? So the big projects. So now we are coming on the conclusion. By using the power rate less than 3 rupees, our desalination water will be available with 3 paisa per liter. Even just like Mumbai, we can purchase an old ship. We can make it ship here near Malwar Hill, where we can make desalination plant and connect it to the hanging garden tank. Somewhere other side, again the other ship will be there. So in place of making big dam, they are spending a lot of money for water problem in the Mumbai. Now we are already in we are signing the agreement between government of Maharashtra and Gujarat for Pinjar and Daman Ganga project. So that project is going to water to Mumbai. But in place of that, if the power rate is less, the desalination of water is less. The rate will be less. So these are the new innovative ideas by which we can create value in solid waste and liquid waste. We have to plan it professionally, and pollution is a big concern. Second is big roads, and the last subject which is very important, which is touching to my heart, that is we are importing petrol, diesel and crude oil. You know the all the things, how we are paying, what are the pollution. I'm talking from last 10 years, making biofuels. And now we have already parliament, cabinet has passed the resolution. The first is we are making ethanol from molasses. The second generation ethanol from cotton straw, wheat straw, rice straw, bagasse and municipal waste, segregated municipal waste, bamboo also we can use it. It can boost the agriculture economy. And third generation ethanol from corn and food grain. So government of India now clear the policy. So 4-5 days before, the Toyota MD Mr. Vikram Kirloskar was with me. And he was telling me about his hybrid car, Camry. I asked him, your car is good, but in Brazil, Canada and USA, you are using flex engine. So why you not make the car, which will be hybrid car, 50% of electricity. And in the car in Brazil, USA and Canada, there are the flex engines are there. You can put 100% ethanol or you can put 100% petrol. Choice is with the consumer. So by which we can reduce the pollution, but it will be import substitute, cost effective and pollution free. Today the TVS and Bajaj, both have now the auto rickshaw, this bike is ready on ethanol. Or ethanol, methanol, biodiesel, bio-CNG and electricity. The methanol from coal, the rate is only 70 rupees per liter in China. There is a lot of thing which developed China, a lot of methanol economies there. And from in Mumbai, the Deepak fertilizer and RCF, they have got the methanol with the rate of 22 rupees per liter. And diesel rate is 60 rupees. By using methanol, they are ready to give this methanol. And Volvo has got an engine on 100% methanol. So I give the proposal to the best that you can start 10 to 20 buses on methanol. Ethanol, methanol, biodiesel, bio-CNG and electric. Electric is a very cheap fuel. We are now coal surplus and electric surplus. Zero pollution. Import substitute, cost effective and pollution free. So my suggestion is for transport, for public transport, 100% we have to think about electricity as a fuel. We have Port Rail Connectivity Corporation in Mumbai and we have already identified 100 projects of ropeway, cable car, funicular railway. And the company which we have shared more than 65% of the world, an Austrian company, they are ready to give technology. We are now planning for making ropeway from this Bombay Port Trust to Nawasheva to Shivri. And by which people can go there. We are also going to start the RoRo service in next month after this. And it will be good easy. People will take their car and bus and going to Mandwa or going to Karjat, Neral. And even we are now appointed already a consultant where it is possible for us to connect it to the new airport in New Mumbai, where people will take the catamaran, hovercrafts or seaplane and they will go there to the airport. So these are the new technology, new visions, very important for the smart cities. And I feel that the mobility, pollution, these are the important sectors. About the planning, that is also where we need the authority like Singapore Planning Authority, the way in which they are developing. And here we need the low-cost affordable housing. We need middle-class MIG, LIG, HIG. And we have to use the different type of new technology of precast. Because I feel that this is a time for the country that we have to make mandatory the precast technology. Because pollution is a big concern. So I feel that the country is changing. We are making a lot of highways. We are making Mumbai-Delhi Express Highway now. The one highway is going to solve a lot of problem. With distance between Mumbai and Delhi, we are going to reduce by 125 kilometers. And it starts from Delhi, Gurgaon, going to Jaipur Ring Road, to Alwar, Alwar to Sawai Madhopur, Sawai Madhopur to Vadodara, and Vadodara to Mumbai. And the most important thing in the planning is the capital cost for land acquisition. If the existing road from Delhi, Ahmedabad, Mumbai, the land cost is 7 crore rupees per hectare. But we are selecting the alignment, which is the backward area of Rajasthan, Haryana, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh. So our land cost is 70 to 80 lakhs rupees per hectare. So only in one project, we are now saving 16,000 crores on land acquisition. And now this already Vadodara Mumbai of 45,000 crores, already we have awarded the contract, the first phase, and work will already they have started. So this is the first phase is already started and I am trying my level best to make this highway to start all this work before December. I don't know, it's a difficult task, but we are trying for that. So new highway will solve all the problem and traffic jam which are here in Mumbai, Ahmedabad and Delhi route. So we have to create new ring roads, new highways and we are planning for that in Bharatmala. And we have a lot of, you know, Bangalore, see what a big problem is there. What big traffic jam, pollution. So everywhere we have to need to be planned by considering the public transport, good on the electricity. Second thing, air pollution, water pollution are big concern. And urban planning is the most important thing. We can make gardens, playgrounds, everything. And that is the need of the smart city. And people are expecting all these good things from us. So I feel that we have to think about this, particularly this air pollution and water pollution is a big problem. We can plan for smart cities, very, very fine approach using all new technology. But at the same time, we have to think about the old urban cities like Mumbai, Calcutta, Chennai, Bangalore, where we are facing the problem. So both things are available by public-private investment. And we can make the things. And I feel that this is the time for the country that we have to go for, not for smart cities, but smart villages also. By our approach, using new technology, affordable technology, using of waste material, I feel that definitely we will fulfill the dream of the people of India. Once again, I'm giving my thanks to particularly the Mint people for organizing this seminar. And from my department, there are a lot of things with me to tell you, but the time is less. I'm very much thankful to them. Thank you very much. Namaskar.